Greetings to all and welcome to the channel Simtech 05. So this is the second video tutorial of Abacus Interactions. In the first video tutorial, I explained contacts or interactions in Abacus briefly and what type of surfaces are required for those interactions. So here you can see we have a number of components in the assembly, like this is the beam component, column component, in between we have one plate component, and we have four bolts also. Two bolts are in this side and two bolts are in this side. Okay. So for such assemblies, it is very, very important to define the interactions or contacts properly. Otherwise, result will be misleading. Apart from in this video tutorial, we will also see how to apply the pretension load for the bolt component. So you can see here up to the 10th increment, here we are getting only the pretension load and stresses are due to the pretension load. And after the 10th increment only, the applied force is in the subject, you can see, okay. So let me play the simulation, just go for play. So up to that we have pretension load, then the incremental load or applied load is start, and after the 10th increment, whatever stresses are generated due to that load will be computed in the step second. So let me continue the process. Just go for here visualization instead of visualization, part modeling. So these components are already created, and if you want to create those components, very easily you can go for creating by part modeling itself in Abacus, or you can import those model from the CAD softwares. So I'm not wasting time in the modeling. After the modeling, we have to go for define the property. In property, we need to create the material, we need to create the section, and we need to assign the section. So just go for create the material by name of steel 235. Define the properties like general property, density 7820 e raised to the power minus 12. Okay, this material is considered in mm, ton and second unit, that's why the density will be look like that. Go for mechanical elastic property, just go for elastic, Young's modulus 210 e raised to the power 3, and the Poisson's ratio 0.3, and the plastic property, plastic and plastic property. The yield stress for the steel 235, we have 235 actually, and the plastic strain value is 0. Okay, this material is for beam, plate and column component. We are going to create another material for the bolt. So define the name, material name as bolt, go for define general property, density 7820 e raised to the power minus 12. Then again go for define the elastic and plastic property. So after defining the materials, we need to create sections. We are going to create two sections. One is for steel 235, type of materials, type of components. Okay, so name also I am giving steel 235. Same material, and another for bolt component. Okay, so just bolt, solid, homogeneous, and select here material as bolt, go for create. Yeah, now we need to assign the property, or we need to we need to assign the sections. Okay, so just go for create. It is asking for components, select this part. I'm not going to create any set, so if you want to create set, just check on and define name, otherwise go for uncheck. Go for done. Okay, so steel property I am assigning here, and similarly for the bolt, yeah, for bolt we have different property. Just select the part and just go for bolt. Okay, similarly assign the property for two other parts. So once property is assigned, you need to go for assembly. Actually, we need to assemble those all components, but I don't want to invest time in assembly actually. As well as I splitted my geometry because I want to define all element as structured mesh. If we are not going to split, software is unable to define the structured mesh. See, here we are not looking the assembly command in briefly and splitting command in brief. We are looking for the interactions, contacts. So the main focus is interactions. So just go for here, step. Okay, at the start of video, I already mentioned we need to create two steps. One is for pretension condition or pretension load. Define name as pretension, static general, continue. Increment, go for some small initial increment that convergence will occur, and maximum increment we need as 0.1. For safe side, I'm taking here 1000 increments, just go for OK. Again, go for creating the second step that as loading step, go for continue, and same parameter, increment parameter we have to define. So you can see here field request and history request is automatically assigned. If you want to make some changes, you can go for it. So after step, you need to define here interaction. That is very, very important step. But before defining interaction, I would like to define some loading conditions. Those are nothing but our pretension loading conditions. So just go for load and go for click on load manager, go for create, say bolt load first BL1. I'm just going to copy this for further use. In the mechanical, you have to go for here bolt load, click on continue. Oh, I'm sorry, we need to go for choose the first step, just go for dismiss it. So this pretension step, click on the bolt load, click on the continue. And now it is asking for interior surface or bolt shank surface. So everyone know the bolt shank, and we need to select the bolt shank surface. But the problem is that if I go for selecting directly, we are unable to select. Okay. So what I have to do, I have to go for here display group options. Just click on that and go for here part or instance. I want to see only on the bolts and this back component, that is column actually. So I'm going to hide my beam and plate. Just go for select those by pressing control, click on remove. Now go for dismiss. Very easily you are able to select now the shank surface or those cylindrical surface. Okay, one more thing, here we have four bolts, so we have to create the load four time. Okay, so bolt shank surface and select this surface. Any of one cylindrical surface you can select this surface, and it is asking for cut position. Okay, the cut position is nothing but like if this one is our cylindrical surface, at what distance or at what percentage value you want to create a cut section, their software will create automatically the pretension load. So at the exact limit I want to apply, so just go for here 50% and click on done. Define the magnitude value. For pretension load, we have value as 90430 and click on OK. See, this one is our pretension load, and those arrows are representing the pretension boundary condition. Similarly, you have to define the pretension load for all bolts. So let me do this. Okay, so all bolt load is defined. I also want to apply the point load. So just go for unhide your assembly. Just click on that icon that is replace all, or you can go for here again the display group and select those all component and click on add. Okay, Otherwise, you can directly use this options and hide the all components. Okay. So to define the point load, again we have to go for create. Okay, the point load I want to create on the loading step, not on the pretension step. Define the name like point load and go for here concentrate load point load. Click on continue. Select this point. I made one split here that I can easily select this point. Define the value that is in the negative y direction. So I'm defining negative and value. Just click on OK. So make sure you are creating the point load in the loading step, not in the pretension step. Okay. And one more thing, whatever the pretension load you are created, that will be propagate for the second step. So we can say whatever the pretension result we have, that will be carry on for the next step. I'm also going to create some constraints. So just go for here, constraint, boundary condition manager, click on create, define any name. I want to fix this column top and bottom. So just go for here, axisymmetric or Ancaster. Just go for select this face as a first face. Okay, when I selecting any face, this is not going to highlight because I unchecked this options. If you want to see the surface before selection, just check on this. And now you are able to see the surface before the selection. Okay. Select this surface. And now click on done. Define Ancaster options. So this component is fixed from these two end. And one mistake we did, by default we created in the loading step. So just go for move left and move left. I want to create this boundary condition in initial step. Okay. Now just go for dismiss. Now the important task to creating the interactions. Okay. So there are two ways to generate or create interactions. One is like manual way, one is auto detection options. Next video tutorial, we will see the auto detection options and what are the limitations of that auto detection options. But now we are using the manual contact assignment. In my previous video, I mentioned that we need to define the contact surfaces for the contact or interactions, and those contact surfaces may be the node basis, may be the element basis. If you define the element based surface, you can select those surfaces for master as well as slave, but the node basis surface can be select only for the slave. I briefly explained those type of surfaces in my previous video. I highly recommend to go with this video, and then only you have to follow the other interactions video. So now let me have an overview where we want to define the contacts or connections. Okay. See, it is very clear. One contact is between column and plate. One contact is between plate and that beam component. Okay. Then we have interactions or contacts between that plate top face and this bolt inner face. Inner face means I will show you inner face. Similarly, we have here contact, the inner face of the bolt and this face. Okay. So these contact I have to create, and there should be tie connection between this plate and this beam component. Okay. I am assuming that those two components are rigidly fixed with each other. So now creating surface is very, very important task. I'm not going to create the interactions directly because it is little bit lengthy here. So first we are going to create number of surfaces, and we will utilize those surfaces to define the interaction definition. Okay. So let me create the surfaces, not part basis surfaces. Just go for hide those parts and go for here in the assembly and surfaces. Okay. See, here we have existing surfaces like bolt surface 1, 2, 3, 4. Why? Because we define the pretension load and software will automatically decided or define those surfaces. So now let me create the another surfaces. Just go for define the first surface as this beam internal surface that going to be connect with plate. So I'm defining as beam. Click on continue. Then you want to select that internal surface of the beam, but that is problematic. you are unable to select that internal surface directly. So what you have to do, you have to go for again those tools, display tool, just click on that display options, and I want to see only on this beam component. So just click on beam and click on intersect. So all other component will be hide. So just go for rotate little bit this component. I'm changing the rotation center and now go for rotate and go for here dismiss. And now you are able to select the surface very easily. Okay, select the surface and click on done. So see, here you have the beam surface. Now again go for show all the components according to the requirement. We will show and hide those components. Now another surface you have to create, this plate top surface. So I'm defining name as plate and TP. This is the top surface. Click on continue selecting the surface. Okay, now again we are getting some problem. Look, if I go for selecting this surface individually, it is too much problematic for me. So instead of individual method, I go for here by angle options, define some angle and select the surface. So whatever surface having the angle less than the 20 will select the automatically. So just go for done. See, the top plate face is selected. So I just go for rename this, not TP, that is TF, plate top face. Okay. Similarly, plate bottom face. So to selecting the bottom face, I need to hide this column component. So just go for here, remove what? Remove this column, or you can go for this tool, display tool, and remove the column component. Just go for here, dismiss. Again, double click on the surface. Say plate bottom face. So bottom face. Click on continue. I want to select those faces. Make sure you are in the angle options. Select one surface and software will automatically detect the all faces. Just click on done. At the same time, I want to create the shank surfaces also for the bolt. So just double click on that and say bolt shank surface SS. Just go for create, define by angle. Select the one surface, software will automatically detect the all other surfaces. Okay, similarly these surfaces and these surfaces. Now go for done. I also want to select the bolt top and bottom inward faces. So for this I have to go for hiding this plate component also. Just go for again the display manager and go for here the hide. Say click on the plate component and click on the remove icon. Okay, so just again double click on that. I'm selecting the bolt top surfaces or top faces. Just click on continue. Again, select this first, second, third and fourth, these faces, and click on done. Similarly, I want to select this bottom faces also. Double click, define the name bolt bottom face or bottom surface. Just click on continue, select these surfaces precisely, select first, second, third and fourth surfaces. Okay, go for display manager, check on the column component. I want to create the surfaces for the column top and column bottom also. So just go for define the name by double click on the surface column top face or top surface. Click on continue. Make sure you are using this options. Now if you want to deselect those surfaces, just again go for here individual method and by pressing control button deselect this and deselect this. Now click on done. And similarly, column bottom surface or bottom face. Click on continue, select by angle options, select this surface and this surface. Now again go for the buy and dissolve options, and I want to deselect those, okay, as well as I want to deselect those. See, those only surfaces are selected. Now click on done. Last, we need to select the surfaces which going to be contact with respect to the bolt shank, okay. So for that, what I'm going to do, I'm going to hide the all other parts. I'm just going to keep the plate component and the column component, okay, plate component, and now click on column and add. So these surfaces are going to be connect with hole shank. So I'm just going to define the name, and I double click on that and defining name as hole shank. Click on continue. Okay, again by angle options, select this surface and this surface by pressing shift button. Similarly here, here also and here also. Okay, those surfaces are selected. Click on done. So now we are done with generating the contact surfaces, and go for here, show all the component, and now we are looking for the contact definition. So before defining the contact, we need to create the property, contact property. Just go for create, okay, interaction property one, or we can say any other name. So say frictional contact, and just go for contact, create mechanical behavior, tangential behavior is penalty based friction, and I'm defining friction coefficient as 0.3, and normal behavior is the hard contact. Just go for OK. I will explain those hard contact and penalty based method. We will talk on those in separately in next video tutorial. Just go for dismiss, go for definition, click on create. So interaction one, or we can say the shank versus hole contact, okay. Make sure you are in the initial step, because I want to define the contact in initial step itself. Surface to surface contact for Abaqus standard. Just click on continue. So I not need to select the surfaces now. I just go for here, the surfaces options, and those all surfaces those I created are available for me. I need to select what? Master surface. So the master surface will be the always larger surface. If you have rigid component, then we need to select the rigid as a master. All those things I explained in my previous video, I suggest to go with that. So this is the for hole shank. This surface is for the hole shank contact. Just click on continue. Now it is asking for the slave. In the slave also I'm going to select the surfaces, and those bolt shank surfaces are my slave surfaces. Click on continue. Define the property, this friction property I already created, and now click on OK. So in this way we have to create the different contact. It is also possible to define different properties for individual contact, okay, but right now I'm just going to create only one property that I already created, and I'm using that property for the all component, okay. So just go for again create the another property. This is between the beam component and plate component, so define name as beam plate, okay. Surface to surface, again continue, select the master surface. Master will be our plate top. This one is the plate top surface, and slave surface will be our beam surface, this beam surface. Just click on continue. Define the property. If you have multiple property, you can define, and just click on OK. Similarly, I need to define the interaction between plate top and this bolt inner surface. Okay, so say plate versus plate top versus bolt inner top. Okay, so I'm defining name as bolt IT. Select the plate top face, click on continue. surface and then go for bolt top face. See, these surfaces must be select. Click on continue, again define the definition and OK. Now again go for creating new property, plate to column. Just click on create, plate bottom, click on continue, then again surface and column bottom face. Oh sorry, column top face. Now click on continue. See, now we have to define the contact between these two faces. Like click on create column and bolt, click on continue. So this one is the bolt bottom actually, and column bottom. So here you have column bottom face, surfaces, and these are the bolt bottom inner. So bolt bottom faces. See, now click on continue and click on OK. So all contacts are defined, but we made one mistake. See, if we have such beam and that connected to the plate with the friction coefficient of 0.3, that will be directly fall down. Okay, so what I earlier told you, we have to define a rigid component, a connection between the plate component and beam component. So the beam plate component should not be connection actually. Here just go for delete, remain all is okay. So I want to define a tie connection between these two components. Just go for dismiss and click on connector options here, and click on those constraint manager, click on create constraint type tie and click on continue. It is asking for master surface. Just go for define the surface. Master one is the plate top surface. So here the plate top surface, plate top, click on continue. Again the slave surface, and for the slave also I need to decide one surface, that is the beams surface. Click on beam surface and click on continue. So again it is asking for some definitions like discretization method and those all. I will explain those also in my future videos. Make sure you are unchecking this options, adjust slave surface initial position, if you don't want to allow any adjustment into node. And rotational degree of freedom also I want to constrain, so check on this options. But here I'm allowing the initial displacement or initial adjustment. Keep this options as it is and go for OK. So now all interactions and constraints are defined. As well we defined the load and boundary conditions also. So now just go for mesh. So as I told you, by mean of some splitting we are unable to define the structured mesh for the component. One more thing, by default my global shading will be create only one element through the thickness. So that's why what I did, I go for the local shading and selecting this edge and selecting this edge, not by angle, individual, and define some number of element like 4 element along depth I want. Okay, similarly for this case also, here also I want the 4 element, okay, along the depth. So I decided, now just go for your mesh options, click on the mesh, select the all part which you want to mesh, click on done. In future I will create a separate video for the meshing and for the splitting in the Abacus meshing algorithm for the 3D components are very very excellent. So I will separately talk on that. So just go for here the job options, make sure you save the file, make sure you save, you define the work directory. Just go for here, save file, set work directory. Okay, I'm choosing some work directory, this one is my work directory. Okay, click on OK. Just go for here, job manager, create job one. Parallelization I want to use multiple core, I'm allowing 16 core memory. See, sometime if you have less memory in your system, the solver shows some error like memory is out of system memory. So you have to uncheck these options, increase memory allocation, based on analysis estimation. Okay, we are just going to fix the RAM or memory up to 90% of the available memory. Okay, we are not allowed to increase that. Let's go for okay. And now click on data check or submit. I am going to submit directly. Click on monitor. Okay, solver start writing the increment files, ODB files. So after few increments, analysis is completed. So let me open the result. Just go for dismiss and click on the result. Go for some standard view. Click on contour options and this is the final displacement. Sorry, one message stresses. If you want to change the stresses to displacement, just click on here. So this will be the displacement. Okay, so displacement result is not that much important here because we already know the maximum displacement will be occur here. Okay, so again go for the stresses and one Mises stresses. So let me verify the pretension results in the first step. So up to 10th or 11th increments, see, up to 10th increment we have here pretension load, and this is the effect of the pretension load on the column. See, by default the color pattern is little bit different. Just go for here contour options and by default it is actually the rainbow options, and now click on apply. So this blue color is represented for the zero stresses. It is little bit disturbing to see the blue color everywhere. So what you have to do, you have to click on that color icon. You have to select, you have to define the name of the spectrum, new spectrum you are going to create. Okay, spectrum 2, and click on that blue icon and again go for double click and choose a default whitish type of color. Okay, click on OK, then OK, and again see, still we are in the rainbow options. Okay, just go for here the spectrum 2, click on apply. So now the lower result will be look like in the gray color, and click on apply. Okay, so these are some visualization options. Actually, just let me play pretension, then whatever the load we applied, accordingly the stresses will be generated. Okay, so I hope lots of things you learned here, and especially how to define the interactions, contact surfaces, and how to define the contact, like how to hide the surfaces, show the surfaces, and those all general things. Okay, this is the software skill, nothing theoretically or conceptually. The conceptual thing I explained in my previous video, and in next video I will also talk little bit conceptually about the interactions properties. Okay, that video will be very important. So be in touch with my channel. If you have any query or question, you can put that question in comment section, or you can message me on WhatsApp, you can call me, or you can mail me also. My details are available in the description. So that's all for this video. Thank you.